Agora vou fazer a lição sobre unidades 3 e 7 para a nona classe. Today's class is for unit 6 and 7 for the 9th standard. Alright? We are using the same book that we have, that is Português 21. Okay? You may turn your page to 94. We will start with the dialogue. It's in the consulting room, so no consultório. I'll just read through it so that you all have the pronunciation. For those of you who do not have the CD or are unable to use the CD on your laptops, alright? Boa tarde, senhora doutora. Boa tarde. Sente-se. Então, o que se passa? Olha, senhora doutora, venho aqui porque me sinto muito cansado. Dói-me as pernas e às vezes dói-me o peito. Eu acho que não é nada de especial, mas a minha mulher está sempre a dizer que tenho de consultar o médico. E ela tem razão. Há quanto tempo é que não vem à consulta? Há mais de 5 anos, talvez. Bem, deixe-me escutar e vamos medir a sua tensão arterial. Algum tempo depois. A sua tensão está muito alta, senhora Oliveira. E o seu coração precisa de um exame maior. Quanto é que o senhor pesa? Uns 90 quilos, acho eu. Pois é, o senhor está muito gordo. Precisa emagrecer e principalmente de ter muito cuidado com o que come e com o que bebe. Bom, mas primeiro vai fazer estes exames. Faça estas análises e um eletrocardiograma. Temos de ver como está esse coração. Acho que posso ter algum problema de coração? Não sei. Temos de esperar pelos resultados do exame e das análises. Mas, entretanto, Sr. Oliveira, não coma gorduras, nem doces, nem beba bebidas alcoólicas e faça exercício. Ande todos os dias um pouco a pé. Bem, eu ao domingo dou sempre um passeio ao pé com a minha mulher. Mas não pode ser só ao domingo. Tem de andar a pé mais vezes. Ok, now this is for you all to understand the dialogue. Now, quickly, I want you all to note down the words that you all haven't understand, ok? So, leiam o diálogo no página 94 de novo. E anotem as palavras que não compreenderam no seu caderno. E agora, ouçam o diálogo que eu já vos li ou através do CD que está atrás do vosso livro, ok? So, what do I want you to do? Read the dialogue again to yourselves and write down the words that you haven't understood in your notebook. And then re-listen to the dialogue which I have already read. Or those of you who have the CD and are able to use it, please listen to the dialogue on the CD. Use o seu dicionário e procure os significados das palavras que marcou. Now, use your dictionary and search for the words that you have underlined or marked in your notebooks and find out the meanings of the words that you have marked. E faça frases deles. And I want you all to write sentences based on the same sentence. Now remember, the word could have different meanings depending on the context. So be careful. Do not just write the first word that you get in the dictionary. Understand the context of the dialogue and then write the sentence and the meaning. Alright? Depois, abaixo temos aqui o pergunta 2. Que são as perguntas. Eu quero que vocês respondam as perguntas abaixo do diálogo nos vossos cadernos. So I want you all to write down the answers to the questions that have been given on the below the dialogue, ok? So the first question is, o Sr. Oliveira vai ao médico da manhã? Does Sr. Oliveira go to the doctor in the morning? Second question, quais são os sintomas do senhor Oliveira? What are the symptoms that he has? And third one, you have to write the question and the answers given to you há mais de 5 anos, for more than 5 years. So what should the question be? Fourth one again, you have to frame the question on your own. Antes, devem primeiro a médica ausculta o Sr. Oliveira e mede a sua tensão arterial, which is first the doctor listens to his, to Sr. Oliveira, and then she takes his tensão arterial, which is blood pressure. Okay? Fifth question, a médica acha que o Sr. Oliveira tem um bom peso? Does the doctor think that Sr. Oliveira has a relatively good weight? Then, sixth question, quais são os exames que o Sr. Oliveira tem que fazer? What are the tests or what are the examinations that Sr. Oliveira has to do? Seventh question, quais são os cuidados que o Sr. Oliveira deve ter? What are the precautions that Sr. Oliveira has to take? Please answer in full sentences. I don't want direct answers of yes or no. Alright? Then, you have the next question, which is question number 3. Now, siga o exemplo e preencha os passos com a indicação correta. Now, you have a table with the different types of doctors, tipos de médicos. Okay? So, for example, you have ophthalmologista, which is an ophthalmologist. Cardiologista, which is a cardiologist, ortopedista, which is an orthopedic, ginecologista, which is gynecologist, dentista, which is your dentist, pediatra is a pediatrician, otorhinolaryngologista, which is a otorhinolaryngologist, which is your ENT, which we simply call ENT, but the medical term is otolaryngologista, okay? Then you have dermatologista, which is dermatologist, neurologista, which is a neurologist. Now, you have understood these words. Some of you are familiar with what they do. But now the exercise is, you've already got what the first one is. Otorrinolaryngologista é um médico que trata as doenças relacionadas com os ouvidos, nariz e garganta. That is your ears, nose and throat, ENT, so that is the otorhinolaryngologista. Second one, I'm giving you, the second one is the doctor that treats children, okay? Médico que trata das crianças, doctor that treats children. Then, the doctor that treats sicknesses related to the nervous system. Okay, fourth one, the doctor that treats the sicknesses or illnesses specific to women. Sixth one, the doctor that treats your eyes. Seventh, the doctor that treats your teeth. The doctor that treats sicknesses related to bones. Okay, the doctor that treats sicknesses regarding your skin. And the doctor that treats sicknesses with regards to your heart. So you have to write what the specialist is called. Okay? You have already got them on the table. You only have to fill them out. Moving on. Now, in the dialogue, se voltarmos ao diálogo, vemos o uso do verbo doer. Now, doer is to hurt. So, vemos o uso do... Na quarta linha, o Sr. Oliveira diz... Dói-me as pernas. And then later on, he also says, dói-me o peito. So, doer has only two forms, okay? Only two forms, and it depends on the subject we're referring to. Sorry, the object that we're referring to. Okay? So, that is, if the object is in singular, you say dói. And if the subject is in plural, you would say dói. Depending on who's saying it, it will be dói-me or dói-me, dói-te, 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 and so on and so forth. You will put the reflexive part of the verb, that is me, te, se, nos, se, or vos. Alright? So, por exemplo, dói-me o pé direito. My right leg hurts. So, you say dói-me o pé direito. Or, you want to talk about his teeth are hurting. You say dói-lhe os dentes, okay? Doem, because you see that dentes is in plural, so you say doem. Pé direito is singular, so you will say doem o pé direito. Now, there is a small exercise at the bottom of page 95, which I also want you to fill out. Completa um pequeno exercício na página 95. Depending on whether singular or plural, you will put doi or doi. Alright? Agora, na página 96, temos o verbo dar. Now, the verb dar, which is to give, in the present indicative, has been conjugated for you in the top part. All you have to do is, depending on which person, that is, eu, tu, ele, ela, você, ou nós, eles, elas, vocês, you will put in the right verb form. Alright? Complete that and then, now. I have also taught you in the previous class, modo imperativo, which is basically what this chapter is based on. So, in question number 5.1 on page 96, you have two tables. Now, the first part is explaining again the formation of the imperative verb. In the second part, you have three blocks that are there. In the first part of the table, the first column says the infinitive verb is given to you. The second column, you have the present indicative that has to be filled. Okay, so you have the first column, which is the infinitive of the verb. The second column is the present indicative form, which I need you to fill in yo. All are in yo. And the third is the imperativo in você. So you have tu and você normally. I want you to fill it in você as given in the textbook. Alright? And then you have the exercise on page 97, which you will also do. Now, I will read out the question to you. It says, no final da consulta, do senhor Oliveira, o médico dá-lhe folheto. So at the end of his consulting, senhor Oliveira is given a prescription by the doctor. Alguns conselhos para proteger o coração. With some instructions and advice to protect his heart. Mas neste folheto faltam os verbos. But on this prescription, the verbs are missing. Complete os conselhos do folheto conjugando os verbos na forma imperativa. So what do you have to do? You have to complete this prescription conjugating the verbs in the imperative form in você, not tu, because here it's a formal situation. Remember, formal situations you also have to use você, okay? And then finish that and on page 98 there is another table that is there. Another table you have here. Again, there is the infinitive form. You have presente indicativo of il. Okay, so you conjugate the same verb il. For example, here you have falar. Il fala. For tu, imperativo in the affirmative, I said is equal to the third person singular of the present tense. So it is the same thing. Fala tu. Okay, so the third column and the second column will be the same. Only that in the imperative, it is the tu form here. Okay, and you have question number 6.1, 2 and 3. Now, you have to practice the use of the verb in imperative. I want you to first imagine. Agora imagine, first question says, agora imagine que está a falar com um amigo. Comigo que tem problemas do coração. Now, you have to imagine that you are talking to a friend who has heart problems, okay? Now, when you're talking to a friend, you know you will use the verb in tu. So, leia-lhe os conselhos do folheto. You're using the same prescription that the doctor has given Sr. Oliveira, but you have to read it to him in the tu format. Sobre coração saudável, mas use o forma tu. Remember, you have to use the form tu. Okay? The second question, so you have to rewrite, you have to rewrite the whole thing, but in the tu format. Remember, the formation of tu and then conjugate it. Read it carefully, just don't copy and paste. Okay? It's simple, but understand it first. Second one, procura algum agora as formas de imperativo no diálogo entre o médico e o Sr. Oliveira e sublinhas. Now, you read the dialogue once again. It's already been used. This imperative form has already been used. So what I want you to do is read the dialogue again and underline the verbs that you find in the imperative tense. Now, obviously it's a formal situation, so you always be in você. The doctor won't talk to you like you're his colleague. Alright? So please underline those. And the third question is, agora imagine os conselhos que a mulher do Sr. Oliveira lhe vai dar depois da consulta. Now what you have to do is imagine what the advice the wife of Sr. Oliveira is going to give him. Alright? So it's about 4 or 5 sentences, again in the imperative form because they are conselhos, which is advice, by the wife. So Sra. Oliveira will give to her husband. Alright? So please do this for your homework and send it to me on my WhatsApp number or the email, and I will get back to you with the corrections. Thank you.